everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Trouble Free. In today's video, we are going to learn about ad hoc on demand distance vector routing algorithm in the subject of mobile computing. So before starting the video, let me tell you something. If you have not seen the video of dynamic source routing protocol which I've done already previously, first have a look at that video and then come to this video, because it is all related to that video itself, right? The entire terminology and everything is same. There is a little difference between that and this that you'll be coming to know with the example. So make sure that you will have a look at that video before watching this, so that you can understand clearly, right? So now, and this is also one of the routing protocol wherein you find the route from the source to the destination, and optimum path you will be finding and all. So let's get into the video. So the same, this also will operate in two phases again. The first one is route discovery and the second phase is route maintenance. Okay, the same as dynamic source routing vector protocol. So that is the reason why I said to have a look at that video once. So it also has two phases, route discovery phase and route maintenance phase. Okay, but what is the difference between the dynamic source routing protocol and this? Means in dynamic source routing protocol, the source will know the entire path to the destination, but whereas here each node has only its previous node and next node information only. That means each node will be knowing only about its previous node and its next node. Okay, see, for example, in this you have A, right? A is the source and F is the destination here. Source and destination. In order to reach from A to F, you have many ways, right? In the previous algorithm, that is in dynamic source routing algorithm, what happens is A will have information only about its previous node and only about its next node. A will have the entire information about all the paths present in the, diagram. But whereas in this protocol, it will have information only about its previous node and next node. That's all. Not about the complete path. Okay. Now, let's see what happens in this with example. And in this, route discovery and route maintenance are similar to the previous algorithm. Here, the route discovery will have the source node ID, it will have the destination node ID, it will have recent sequence number, it will have broadcast ID, hop count, time to live, and so many factors it will be having, the route discovery one. Whereas in the previous one, the route discovery one has only the unique request number, it has the source ID and the destination ID. That's all, right? But here there are many factors, and let's quickly get into the example so that you'll understand it clearly with example. If I'm telling it with example, then I need not stress so much on theory part, because you'll understand it very easily with example. So let's see what are the different possibilities we have to reach F from A. Number one is A to, this is C, C to D, and D to E, and E to F. Number two is A to C and C to E, and C to E, we don't have any path, right? So let's stop it here. Let's see. A to C and C to D and D to F, let's go. Okay. And the third path, let's take it as A to B, B to D and D to E and E to F. And the fourth path, let's take it like, or else we can go in this way also. A to C, C to D, D to B and B to F, right? And we have many paths like this. I'll write it here. The fifth path, we can take it as A to D and D to E and E to F. And the sixth path, like if you keep on writing, you'll be getting so many paths. And the next path, you can take it as A to B and B to F. And the seventh path, you can take it as A to D and D to F. So among all the paths, we'll have one more path, I guess, which would be probably A to B, B to D. Oh, B to D is already written, I guess. So yeah, let's leave it. Let's leave it here. If you can write still more, you write it, that's your wish. But still, it's enough to write it till here. See, among all these paths, which of them are optimal, you have to choose. That means which of them are having very less number of intermediate nodes. Path number 6 and path number 7, right? So among these two paths, you can select one path. That's your wish now, right? It's not mandatory that you select B or you select D. You can, select any of the two paths from here, but make sure that you will be choosing the minimum path, optimal path. So what is the difference between the dynamic source routing protocol and this distance vector routing is, in dynamic source routing protocol, this A will have the information about C, about D, about E, and about F. But whereas in this, in distance vector routing, A will have information only about its previous, no previous, right? So it will have only info about C, and C will have info only about A and only about D. So only about previous and next info, that's all. Like any other information you will not be knowing in the case of distance vector routing protocol. You will know only the information of the previous and the next, whereas in dynamic source you'll know the information about the entire path. Okay, so let us select a path now. A to B and B to F is the path we have selected. Let us suppose this is the optimal path only, no? So we can go with this path now. So A to B and B to E. So B to F, what is this? R request, which means route request. And how route reply will be? F to B and B to F. So the route reply will be following in the reverse order of route request. Okay, so the route request is coming in this way and the route reply is being sent in this way. Okay, so among all the possible paths, you have to select a single path, right? And I hope you are clear with the difference between dynamic source routing protocol and also ad hoc on demand distance vector routing protocol. It's very easy. So that's all for this video, guys, and thanks for watching the video. If you have understood clearly whatever I explained in this video, hit the like button and also share it with your friends so that it will be useful for them as well. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and also share it with your friends. And if you're still having any doubts, let me know in the comment section. And let's meet up in the next video with some of the routing algorithms left over in mobile computing. And still then, stay tuned to my channel and also subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can receive the notifications whenever I post a video. And that's all. Let's meet up soon in the next coming video with another topic. And also, let me know in the comment section what are the topics that you guys want me to make videos on, like, you know, any video recommendations. I would be happily taking them. And so that's all for this video. Let's meet up soon.